Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
Though the popularity of SUVs is reigning over the demand of sedans globally, there's one particular segment of these three-box style vehicles that refuses to go down. I'm talking about the sub-4-meter sedan segment, of which India is the birthplace. The demand in this segment is such that we currently have 6 models of different makes competing with each other to get the biggest slice of the pie. And amongst these is this, the Ford Aspire. The Ford Aspire in its petrol manual variant has been part of the Express Drive's long-term fleet for the past 3 months, and we have clocked more than 4,000 kilometers on its odometer. In this video, I'm going to be telling you about how this car performs across various parameters and how my overall experience has been. Welcome to Express Drives. First, let's talk about the driving dynamics of this car. The Ford Aspire comes with a 1.2-liter 3-cylinder petrol engine, which is capable of churning out 96 HP of power along with 120 Nm of peak torque. The 4,000 kilometers that I've covered on this car, most of them have been in the city during peak rush hour traffic. This gave me an opportunity to see how this engine actually performs in its natural habitat. The meat of this engine lies between 1500 to 2500 RPM. There's enough low-end grunt to get you moving and keep up the momentum, but not enough to tread in a higher gear at lower speeds. With fully loaded, as well as a trunk full of monthly groceries, the engine never felt out of breath. We were able to achieve a fuel efficiency figure of 13.6 km per liter in the city and 17.4 km per liter on highway, averaging at about 15.5 km per liter, which I would say is quite decent. The engine is paired to a 5-speed manual gearbox, which offers slick shifts. The only gripe is the heavy clutch pedal. In normal driving circumstances, it won't bother you. However, if you get stuck in traffic, it might result in a fatigued left knee. The brakes offer good feedback and work efficiently even under emergency situations. The Ford Aspire has an overall good visibility. Coupled with a light steering wheel, it is highly maneuverable in tight situations. The Aspire comes with a slightly stiffer suspension setup. It moves over small bumps and potholes quite easily. However, it's the bigger ones that filter inside the cabin. The stiff suspension setup translates into good stability on higher speeds. The Aspire retained its composure even when facing undulation at higher speeds. Talking about the NVH levels, I would say they are quite decent. However, there's a lot of road noise as well as tire noise that creeps inside the cabin, especially at higher speeds. The Ford Aspire comes with a 6.5-inch touchscreen infotainment system. Not only does it look aesthetically pleasing, but it is also quite convenient to use. It comes loaded with Ford's Sync 3 in-car infotainment software and also offers support for Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. The touch response is quite quick and it always connected to my phone instantly over Bluetooth. For using Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, you have to physically connect your phone to the USB port which are available in the car. And the Ford Aspire offers two of them, which are illuminated, which increases their ease of access at night. However, the place provided to keep your smartphone might turn out to be a little bit small considering the average size of smartphones currently available in the market. The physical buttons given to operate the infotainment system are quite big and can be operated even while on the move. However, I seldom use them as the Aspire comes with steering mounted audio controls. The Sync 3 comes with voice command support, and leaving a few instances aside, it did what it was asked for. All that said, I found the sound system of the Ford Aspire, which consists of 4 speakers, to be a bit underwhelming. Despite adjusting all the sound settings, of which there are plenty on offer, I was often left wanting for more. With Delhi observing a lukewarm monsoon season this year, in the past month, the weather has been nothing but humid. The Ford Aspire's automatic climate control worked quite efficiently and was able to keep me cool on my office commutes. However, the air vents themselves, be it the central ones or the one available on the side, offer restricted maneuverability, which can be inconvenient at times. Spending close to 2.5 hours daily in the Aspire's driving seat, I can say that this car offered decent amount of comfort. The driver's seat can be adjusted for height and the steering can be adjusted for tilt, and hence getting into a decent driving position is not a difficult task. However, the availability of a central armrest would have made things better. The Ford Aspire comes with rain sensing wipers as well as automatic headlamps. Both of these automated creature comforts performed according to expectations. However, at times the rain sensing wipers did not activate despite the windscreen being covered in rain entirely, and at times operated maximum speed with just a few drops of rain. In the past 3 months, the Ford Aspire has done everything we have asked it for. It comes with a decently equipped cabin, it is quite comfortable and comes with a fuel-efficient yet enthusiastic engine to drive. Yes, it has its quirks in terms of the NVH levels, a heavy clutch pedal among others, but none of them are really deal-breakers. If you are looking for a subcompact sedan, you should definitely consider the Ford Aspire. That's it from our side, I hope you liked this video, and if you have any other questions regarding the Ford Aspire, do let us know in the comment section below. Until next time, see you!